Hey buddy, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance Series. Happy Monday, Mosh Pit. I hope you all had a great Mother's Day and also a great weekend. Thank you all very much, everyone. We are now only five away from the keyboard tracking episode. There's two other videos from last week that are actually very, very close to 3,000 likes, so definitely go check those out if you've not already. Last week was a lot of great videos, and hopefully this week is also going to follow that trend. So is your meme of the day, actually picture of the day, submitted here by T Blue Ward. Title of the thread was, "My cat passed away a few days ago. Found this old video where he seems to be enjoying watching Sinvicta with me and felt like sharing it. P.S. Sorry for the bad quality video." Thank you very much, T Blue Ward. I sent my condolences on the Reddit thread. But now you can have a little bit of extra comfort knowing that your cat, he is officially immortalized here in the Isaac Victa series. And thank you for allowing him to be part of the Mosh Pit. We will always remember him. And if you want to go see the full video, it's actually really, really cute. Go check it out on this Invicta subreddit /r/Invicta. Thank you, T Blue Ward. Again, sorry about your loss, but now he can be forever remembered here in the Mosh Pit. So thank you very much for sharing that memory with us. Here we go. Let's see what kind of, okay. Lodestone, oh boy. Bravo, Tango, 07, 6 Lima, Mike, 6. Well, we've got good tiers, good damage, good shot speed, good movement speed, and we also have Lodestone, which is not an item that you see me ever really use because I'm just not a fan of Lodestone. It causes more problems than it solves, let's put it that way. It's another one of those items, but I am happy at least that we're starting off with a Guppy item, so that's already, you know, making our job a lot easier to get towards Guppy. I think this is an excellent room here, for at least for a chance to get that tinted rock, and we don't have to end up using the Guppy's paw. There we go, and we get 2 soul hearts. Oh my goodness! We also get ourselves a wooden chest over here, which is going to give us a whole bunch of nothing. But yeah, 2 soul hearts there. So that basically that saves me from having to sacrifice one of our red heart containers and turn it into a soul heart. Now, Lodestone, on the other hand, is a tier effect that's going to basically magnetize whatever it hits in terms of enemies. So it can be useful for crowd control, but the problem is that it also basically attracts every single projectile in the room, including Isaac's, and it's not great, especially if you end up lodestoning something that's like running toward you, like a Globin or a Mully Boom or something like that, and it doesn't die. It can inadvertently pull stuff towards Isaac faster than you can move. So think of it, and you might be asking yourself, like, well, what's the difference between that and Stranger Tractor? Well, that's a good question there, Doug. Yeah, it's just one of those items that's kind of like, do we really need another item like this instead of adding, just like, you know, a damage upgrade? Deep pockets will be cool. I'm going to use the world card now to get ourselves a crawl space. And it's going to give us a black market. Dude, we have been on fire with these black markets. So get a little bang. Oh, my goodness gracious. Won't mind if I do. Keeper sack on floor 1. Yes, sirree, Bob. So that's going to be good enough for us to maybe get deep pockets if we bomb the donation machine. Obviously, with the end of last week, leading up towards the end of last week, we've been putting a lot, and I mean a lot of money in our donation machine. And this is why you really shouldn't feel all that bad for doing so, because it's there to help you in future runs, you know. Obviously, with Repentance, they ended up taking away our ability to... they took away our ability to bomb the donation machine infinitely, which is still a very puzzling change. So, you know, being forced to adapt towards what it is now is, you know, the donation machine becomes even more valuable to keep it stocked. So when you do have to end up bombing it, you get enough money to get whatever you truly need out of the shop. Obviously, big time damage upgrade there, from Keeper Sack. That's exactly why you get it. Now we're going to have Deep Pockets, which is also going to therefore feed back into Keeper Sack after only a couple payouts. Then, of course, we can start getting more shop items, start getting more stats, and it just starts snowballing out of control. That's just how you gain what I like to call momentum in Isaac. Now, you hear a lot about momentum in sports. You hear a lot about momentum in other video games. It's the same premise here in Isaac. You do have momentum, the sort of momentum factor that you can start building upon. Think of it like a stone rolling down like a snowy hill. It's going to start accumulating, start getting a lot of snow, start getting a lot of ice. Next thing you know, you got yourself a very powerful attack that takes 3 turns to do. But you know, when you finally get it rolling, the ice attack is good against most Pokemon. Like it's supposed to be a Pokemon joke in there. All right, I've been playing a lot of Pokemon. The deck that I have right now is absolutely bonkers, and I'm not even going to try to take credit for it, but it's a deck that won the Japanese Nationals last weekend, and oh my goodness, it is good. So, yeah, I've been having a lot of fun destroying the ladder with that. We could have gone back and bought that Soul Heart inside the shop, but I decided not to because we already have enough Soul Hearts, and that one Soul Heart's not going to make a difference anyway in the amount of Devil Deals that we're going to be able to take on this floor. But what is going to make the amount of difference is that those 5 cents being unable for us to buy a premium item, therefore not really capitalizing on Keeper Sack as much as I would like. So that is the reason why I decided not to end up buying that Soul Heart. And look at that right there. We end up getting one from the freaking fortune cookie. My goodness, this is already getting out of control, y'all. Like, in a big way. This is already starting to get some craziness going. Nice temperance machine here. It's going to allow us to cash in these red hearts, also getting up to 12 cents. Again, going back into the premise of feeding more money into Keeper's Sack, therefore also giving us more stats, making us stronger, yada, yada, yada. You see where this is going. That's the momentum that I love to talk about. 14 cents now, one short away from getting ourselves a premium item. We could blow open this this Fool's Gold. I know the secret room is here. And oh mama. 9 more cents. All we need now is a key to get inside of the store, and we are going to be a happy camper, Isaac. Of course, the fortune cookie does also have a chance to pay out with a hermit card, which would be nice. I don't think you can pay out with a key, though. Yeah, it can be a Soul Heart, Terror Card, Rune, or Soul Stone, or Trinket. Trust good people. That's also, like, really important. There's not too many people in this world that I trust. I've been too trusting and too kind to too many people who've squandered that trust away. Now it's gotten to the point where, like, I just don't trust pretty much 99% of the people that I talk to. I'm just going to be honest with you. If I don't already trust them, I mean. Let's put it this way. Let's put new people that I talk to and meet. I immediately have a distrusting nature of them. Unlucky timing there with the rotation of... okay, I'm just going to do this song dance again. Unlucky rotation with the cube of meat there. You get ourselves a Yave, so follow the dog. There's no dog in the game. There was Max, then got turned into Cricket. Man, this is tough. I'm going to buy the Bible. We don't have to bomb the donation machine, but I'm going to. There we go. I'm going to stick with the fortune cookie because fortune cookie is actually just better than the coupon. What would be smart is to take the coupon into the first devil deal just in case if we end up getting multiple devil deals that we want to take. And we can't afford both because we only have 5.5 soul hearts or 5.5 HP total, which is not going to be enough for us to take 2 premium items from the devil deal. But I mean, just look at our damage already, like 8.27. Our tiers have already doubled in size from when we started. And that is just indicative of a Keeper Sack run just through and through, man. My God. Black Pin has no chance in the world. We get Dad's Lost Coin, which is... I'm going to wait on the Eternal Heart, and it's going to be the Nizzail, which we are going to pizzazz on, but I'm going to use the Kazupon for it. And, you know, it does give us 1 of 3 for... It is going to give us 1 of 3 for Leviathan. We care about that. I mean, we do care about the Leviathan transformation because it does give you Soul Hearts and flying, but it's not as good as the Fortune Cookie. I'm just going to be real with you. We can go back and go into the cursed room now. This is going to cost us a soul heart, but the potential there for a guppy item is definitely going to be strong enough for me to at least go check out. And there's not, of course, so. Then now we can go back and play the Temperance Machine to get a couple extra cents. I'm not going to play the Demon Judgment. It's totally wasted on the Demon, not Judgment, but Three Skull Monty here. Our red hearts are far more valuable as money because, again, money equals stats in this situation. We're going to be able to give ourselves more stats via Keeper's Sack. And it also just gives us more power because, remember, those shop items are really, really powerful as well. So it's all in the name of making sure that we are staying alive, staying ahead of the curve, and basically just using every strength that we have to our advantage. And in this case, it's going to be our money generating, our economy, which is going to be helped by way of Deep Pockets, which feeds, of course, into a Keeper Sack. Very, very strong opening here for this run. Now, this is one of the few times where Lodestone actually does help you. As long as you can hit a target that's far away from Isaac, you don't have to worry about anything else getting anywhere close to you because Lodestone will just suck them all up, and then you basically are just going to stay safe. Utilizing your range, making sure you're staying max range from stuff is going to be very, very important. Look at that fortune cookie, I tell you what. Have ourselves a tinted rock right here. So that you can spot the difference there between the rocks, but if you can't, then it's right there. Agent, excellent item. Very good for crowd control, very good for AoE, very good for clearing out early game enemies and swarms of enemies. Contagion is just, That's just what it is. Now, I can't really call Contagion a tier effect. It's more of like just an effect. If that makes sense. Okay. A whole lot of nothing going on. I can't believe that the secret room's not there. Secret room might be south of here, maybe. This one's a little bit more unlikely. Look at that, another soul heart. Four rooms later, we get two soul hearts. Pandora's box would not be bad if we can get it. Also, I mean, I wouldn't mind an angel deal here either. Come on, Deep Pockets. Come on, Deep Pockets. Get ourselves another full charge or another soul heart from the full charge on Fortune Cookie. And we basically are just waiting for Deep Pockets to pay out with 3 cents so we can go get Pandora's box. If we can buy a premium, if we can average one premium item per floor, that is just an incredible amount of extra stats that we're getting from Keeper Sack. Like, it's so dang important to understand how much of an advantage Keeper Sack gives you. This is going to give us a boss item here, and it's just regular old HP. I don't know why you would expect anything else. But it did give us more stats. I mean, more movement speed is fine with me. We didn't quite get damage there, but not that big deal. You saw there briefly while Mega Fatty was in the air that he was actually attracting the tears towards his position despite not being there. That just shows you the sort of crowd control properties of Lodestone. And in a way, I would say that Lodestone is better than Strange Attractor because at least Strange Attractor, or at least Lodestone, doesn't cause the enemies to go at you faster than you can move necessarily. Whereas Lodestone, it can make other enemies move towards that enemy. But Strange Attractor, on the other hand, will just straight up screw you because obviously things are just running faster, and then you've got the Magnetic Pulse, which is just making them even faster and faster. And oh my goodness, we got ourselves a little play here. You may have noticed me take a little bit of a peek up at the top right-hand corner. This is going to take a while, but, you know, a Sacrifice Room play is definitely going to be in the cards here. I still can't believe the Secret Room is not to the left of there. If this pays out, but preferably give us just a ton of red hearts here, please. Okay, it's not a ton, but it's good enough. No pouts of coins there, unfortunately. The ladder, or stairway, I mean. So stairways, you know, it's very similar to what we had last week here. where we're going to get this nice little synergy between Keeper Sack and the Stairway. The Lover's card. I don't mind losing all this HP here. We just get our Soul Hearts right back. So we still have a Lover's card that we can use for the next floor if it does have a sacrifice room. But now we run into a situation where we have to start splitting our money between, do we want to use this for the shop, or do we want to save it for the Angel Shop? Now, obviously, the Angel Shop's going to demand more money. It's just going to demand more currency because of just the higher quality items in there. But in turn, we get paid out with an equal amount of extra stats thanks to... We'll get this key so we can at least open up those golden chests over there. I don't care about losing two Soul Hearts. We've got plenty of HP. Seagram's here, by the way. I noticed that. Okay, we get a nickel. It's not good enough to buy anything in the Angel Shop unless this... We have to hope that this this golden chest here pays out with something buku. Okay, 14 cents. We might be able to get another key here. We're not done yet. It'd be a Christmas miracle here if we're able to get something out of the Stairway Shop on the next floor. Because, I mean, we had no money going into that floor until now. Finding that secret room, definitely important. Again, stressing the importance of just being able to understand where the secret rooms are. Don't think we're going to get another key in here, unfortunately. But we do get 17 cents, which is good enough to get a premium item out of the store. I'm going to be super lazy and just do this. Super secret room is actually right here. Okay. Okay, we'll go back to the boss, the mob trap room, I guess, and it was destined for us to go open up the second golden chest. And it, I mean, we got our bombs back, so. But again, stressing the importance of understanding how to find those super secret rooms and regular secret rooms is so, so vital. Excuse me. The Hierophant. Maybe we can get an Eternal Heart out of here, maybe. The Soul Heart, but all right, see what we get. $0.17 here for the Angel. Yeah, so keep an eye on our damage and our stats. Watch this. Yeah, that is you love to see it. I'm not gonna bother fighting Uriel here just because Gabriel. I just don't want to. We're probably going to get another Angel deal very soon, so. And if we do actually need the key there to go to Megastan, we'll just simply go get it out of the Angel Shop. I know I'm taking a lot of damage here. It's because, quite frankly, I just don't care about our HP. We have so much of it. And on top of that, remember, we've got ourselves one of the best Soul Heart generators in the game in the form of the fortune cookie. So that's why I'm confident enough just to do this now, even though we're just starting on this fourth floor here. It doesn't matter to me. Get teleported to the Angel Room, and we get ourselves Holy Grail with another HP upgrade. Get Scapular as well. Scapular's fantastic. It also gives us Seraphim, dude. Wow. This is... Yeah, and 30 cents, that's beautiful. This is one of the few times where we actually want to see money instead of Soul Hearts, because remember, Keeper Sack, Angel Room, or Angel Shop, yada, 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 yada. Look at that. Contagion just blowing this entire room out of the water. Neat little trick there. Yeah, you'll have to rewind it a little bit, but notice this trite right here. It actually got sucked into the spike because Lodestone procced on top of one of the leapers. And that was a neat little... I noticed that, Lodestone. Don't worry. I brought attention to it so the mosh pit knows to go rewind it and go check it out. I noticed it. I see you. I catch almost everything, man. Secret room might be here. This is an unlikely spot, though. Okay. That one's more like 50-50, if anything. I'm in this location next to this big room. Although now that I see the big room, now I know that the shop is going to be adjacent to it. Yeah. We can use a bomb or a key. Honestly, I think using a bomb to get in there via the secret room is probably going to be better because we've been kind of needing keys for all these mega chests we've been finding. Wheel of Fortune. Good timing on the Wheel of Fortune card. We can plonk it down right before we bomb our way into the shop and possibly get ourselves some money and keys. Or just a key, that's fine too. We get Diplopia. We've already been in the Angel deal. We can take Diplopia. Man, that's a tough call. That is a real tough call. That's a hard sell on me to get rid of Fortune Cookie, man. It really, really is. Because Diplopia, yes, Diplopia can be good. But we can... Man, this is tough. I don't know if we're going to stick with Diplopia. I mean, we already got the stats from Keeper Sack. It's just that, man, the amount of HP you get from Fortune Cookie is just ridiculous. On top of that, the tarot cards, the runes, the soul stones. Dirty looks very weird. Magnetized by Lodestone. I think we're going to have to give up Diplopia. Maybe we'll get a double boss drop here or something. I mean... Double speedball is not terrible because it does count for double spun or a double contribution to spun, and we also get two speed upgrades and a shot speed upgrade. So, yeah, I'm actually fine with that. Buy this, we buy this, we buy this, and we bomb this just to get our nickel back or not. That's fine. Big time plays. And curse the XL. Get the wafer. Beautiful. Look at that. Almost a full damage up and range up here just from simply buying something. We have a chance here to make boss rush. Although unlikely, it is possible. If we go the right way and also find our full card very quickly. But obviously we're not going to prioritize it, especially with us not having Diplopia anymore. Take these though. Now, little gishes are definitely where Lodestone starts to lose my interest rapidly. Because all of them do cross shots, and when they're all kind of jostling around and being pulled which way and that, it makes them shoot very, very difficult shots to dodge because they're so unpredictable. 12.48 damage here. 90% of that damage was from us simply buying things out of the Angel Deal shop as well as the regular shop. Got a little bit of love from Jesus Juice, but that was about it. Ansa's? Of course, the wafer is going to give us essentially double HP from the womb and beyond because we can only take a half heart of damage now. Is very, 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 very strong. And we found the other dead end. All right. We did it, everybody. Congrats. High five. High five. On God, FR. No cap. Full of Pain, or Soul of Lazarus. Let me just go ahead and just chuck you aside right there. I'm gonna bomb the Judgment for the increased chance of a Devil Deal or Angel Deal. I'll take either one. Fortune Cookie just getting us back up full strength with HP here as we continue to look for any room at all. There we go. Obviously totally worth it there. We're getting tons of keys now. Go Contagion doing work for us. Another Wheel of Fortune. I'm just going to go ahead and bomb it now. Get the left hand for some reason for the second time. Even though we've already fought Ultra Pride here. Get ourselves the guaranteed crawl space. No black market this time, but we are going to get plenty of money. Yeah, we can bulldoze a little bit of our HP here as well. Now, the only exception to the half-heart interval rule with the wafer is going to be our Rotten Heart. I'm not going to get rid of our Rotten Heart because I like having the little fly that we get from it every now and then. This helps us out a little bit with DPS. Okay, let me tell you something. These arcing shots we've been seeing from the Fat Isaac torsos lately have been ridiculous. On stream and off stream, they have been absolutely unbelievably accurate. I'm a little bit upset that I didn't know that there was going to be a sacrifice room here, but one thing we could do is we could go just straight for Lamb. We're definitely powerful enough, but I'd like to get more tiers though. 2.99 is still pretty doo-doo. This stage of the run. Oh man, but that is not though. Tech point fizzle. Yeah, so we need to find our fool card. Yeah, that's a lot of keys. First card is not what we're looking for. We could just simply use Ventricle Razor. I mean, it does give us more. There's a Tinted Rock hiding right here. Top rock right here. You can see the X. Little rascal trying to hide from me. Thigh is okay. What we're going to do is we're going to use the Ventricle Razor after we're done with the Devil Deal or Angel Deal, if we do get one. They go back to the shop. Then we can play the Sack Room. Do not get either one, so there's that. Grab this heart. We'll go back to the shop, grab that, come over here. Then we can go play some sacrifice room fun. Sacrifice rooms become so much better with the wafer. Look at that. We get another teleport here. Unfortunately, it's for a crappy item, but might as well use it just for one wisp, I guess. Honestly, I think I'm okay with the idea of just going straight to the dark room. Well, we are missing out on a couple of Angel Deal shops. That's nice though. That money back. We really don't need to fight your Gabriel here. I'm just gonna back out. Go grab those two soul hearts before we go teleport to dark room. This basically just makes us skip Lamb, or skip straight to Lamb, which is kind of nice because we don't have to go through Shoal. Yeah, it's 350-50s game. Okay, first things first, I'm the realist. Second thing first, we're going to go in here. Glyph of Balance, Eternal Heart, and Trinity Shield. I'll take Glyph of Balance. Eternal Heart's going to be good. can still use the holy card for something. Not feeling Damocles. We do have the ability to... We have the ability to protect ourselves here. But it's not... We take Damocles levels of protection. Plus, it's really, really... I mean, it's literally as late as it could possibly get for Damocles here. Even though we're most likely going to do a victory lap here, I'm not feeling it. It's not the not in the cards this time around. Really, what it comes down to is that there's no need for Damocles. Let's put it that way. We have no reason to take Damocles, even if we're doing a victory lap. You're seeing how all the tiers are curving towards the dark one here. Try to get out of the door as fast as possible. Oh, wow, we went straight to land. Use the Empress card here just to get a little bit of extra damage. The only consequence of this is that we lose an Eden token, but I'm in no need of Eden tokens, so the concept of the Eden token was just dumb in my opinion to begin with, but you know, it has its, I don't know, some people like him, I guess. We DPS Lamb down pretty much evenly. Yeah, we're going to do a victory lap. Second seed, Tango Kilo Hotel Romeo, Foxtrot Tango 8 Romeo. And that is Eden Soul, which we do not have enough money for. We still don't have enough. Shame, because I definitely would think about taking it, but at the same time, Eden Souls, it's only really good for... I mean, it's a single-use item, so, like, there's not a whole lot that you're going to really... You can use it as... You can use it inside of the secret room. That's about it. It's all the holy card. Oh, my goodness. There's the dream right there. The triple... Actually, the dream is triple dime payout, but triple nickel payout's really, really nice. To save the money for the angelic shop. Not a good matchup for Larry Jr., I can tell you that. Finally, we get ourselves a tiers up. Holy moly. Took forever, but we finally get our tiers up. Go check out the Angelic Shop here. Pascal Candle. I mean, it's 30 cents, so it's going to be more. It's just going to be more tiers for us, basically. Hot Bombs will go ahead and take as well. So Pascal Candle works. As long as we haven't taken any damage, it is going to give us a tiers up. Any enemy damage, anyway. By the way, if you're wondering how come our damage did not go up very much when we bought it, it's because, remember, we have money equals power. And money equals power is naturally going to lower our damage every time we spend money because it's... Oh! Well then... We're doing okay. You know, this run's going all right. Still have Apollyon. Still technically have Devil Deal protection. But honestly, I'm down with going Angel Deals here, y'all. Like we didn't even sniff another Guppy item for the rest of that last run. So why not? Stanley's on break. He's taking a siesta. Go over here and go check out the shop real quick. Again, we're just fueling the fire here with Keeper Sack. And I'll buy it just for the stat up. Remember, we are losing money. It means we're losing damage. But The fact that we're still gaining damage, despite spending 10 cents with money equals power, is truly remarkable. Should be there. Might be here. Bomb him. So I'm gonna reject Stanley here. Well, actually, we can't reject Stanley because we've already done a devil deal inside of the black market, so we might as well take a look. And yeah. A balance again. I think I'm gonna just pass on it. Hoping that maybe we can get some mapping or something. Wow, we get another sacrifice room. This is getting out of control now. Now, thus going alt path, I'm a little bit more hesitant to take more risks for sacrifice rooms. Did we find our white fire? Is it in here? Oh, okay. Here it is. Impy is going to be great for HP retention as well. And we might as well just go get the knife piece real quick. And I guess I'll buy it again just for the stats. It almost doesn't make sense, though, to do that. No pun intended there. Just because of, like, the money that we're losing with us having money equals power. But whatever. I'm pretty sure that the effects of Cliff of Balance don't stack. And having homing tech 0.5 is just brings a tear to my eye. By the soul heart here. Now we can probably get away with playing the sack room. Chimera room. They might be asking themselves, Victor, how'd you know the super secret room is there? Haven't even been on this floor yet, nerd. That's not true. I've actually been on this floor zillions of times. There's certain wall patterns and floor patterns that you just recognize. And I know that seems like it seems a little pretentious to say that, but it is true. You are able to very easily recognize where secret rooms and super secret rooms are. Most of the time, just from playing the game. Oh yeah, I gotta remember that we have the wafer, so there's actually no danger for us to go play these sack rooms here. Plus, of course, sacrifice rooms just don't feel like paying out with anything. That's, you know, fine too. Soul heart, we'll go ahead and take. More money. Again, that's great for us because obviously this is going to give us more firepower for the angelic shop. No need to fight Gabriel. Go grab the soul heart from inside the I Am Error room and then we will head on. Someone made a remix of that. Which I got a lot of laughing out of, honestly. Whenever I see those kind of like Sinvicta remixes stuff, it makes me laugh so damn hard. Holy Mantle is just going to give us just ridiculous amounts of survivability, more so than we already have. No hearts, okay. Moon card takes us to the secret room, but looking for that sack room. And our damage is going to continue to increase and increase here because of money equals power. Hangman is just flying. We already have flying, so see how the arrow points up here. You want to call this an arrow? Those of you who are more phallically minded, you might think it looks like something else, but shame on you. We don't need any more Red Heart HP. Best thing to do for the red bombs, just hold them until the very last second and then just yeet them over there. Again, we don't need any more red hearts. We don't need no red hearts. Yat-da-yat-da-yat-da. Our wisps. Again, only buying this just because trying to get our stats up with Keeper Sack. It just raises the minimum value, the floor, if you will, of our damage by that much more. Nice Keeper Sack. We do get Capricorn. I know, shout out to Sausage. It became a meme. Shout out to Sausage for being stat up that I forgot. The all stats up. Go ahead and smelt that. Coupon, I mean, I'll buy it for stats. Mom's key. Now we're talking, coach. Pulling hourglass. Okay, let's play the sacrifice room here. Gimpy. Oh my god, dude. Look how many the soul hearts have just been flowing here thanks to Fortune Cookie. Gimpy also paying out big time plays here. Again, more soul hearts thanks to Gimpy. I didn't even know the secret room was there, to be honest. Okay, now it's just a ridiculous amount of soul heart. Would have much preferred getting the money there, but what can you do? Yeah, so we need to go get the golden knife or the other. You're telling me this bomb missed that? Okay, game. For a game that touts to be so accurate, you sure are an accurate game. See, the thing is that I don't really want the broken magnet, so if you could just, okay. Disappeared. We got a really annoying field here. Take your time here. Don't let the demon fires take you by surprise. Just extinguish them. Mother really is of no threat in this entire section, really. Patience is key here. There's no time limit, so you don't have to rush and run and freak out and stuff. Simply just olay her that way, olay her this way, and then about it. Easy peasy stuff. Yeah. Oh my, they give you a hangman card? Don't mind if I do. No problem at all. No problemo. The dime getting our damage back up to somewhat respectable levels, but we're going to need more money for the Angel Shop. The tiers up. Totally fine with that. Remember, our tiers are still being... I don't think we need Genesis. Gotta be honest. We've come this far. We come this far to let this build just sing, and I'm just going to let it do that. And some of you might be like, oh, that's no fun. It's like, okay, like, you know, having fun is great and all. I'm having fun right now. Why change this build? What, you know, do we need to Genesis? Is Genesis going to change the outcome of this run? Probably not. Are we going to be as powerful as this run as we are with Genesis? Probably not. I mean, we're really, really freaking strong right now. Like, really strong. This is a little bit dangerous. Doing this on Curse of the Unknown, but... given the fact that we have Gimpy along with Nun's Habit, along with Fortune Cookie, I think we're going to be just fine. And we also have Scapular, keep in mind. And Scapular will proc and let us know when we're at low life here. Mo' money, mo' damage. Triple lucky penny, you love to see it. All right, fine. Siren here. Do you want to call that a fight? Do you get another angel deal? We're getting really lucky with these procs, man. And, yep. I know we're skipping this shop, but I think we'll be okay. Something tells me we're going to be just fine on this run. And Curse of the Unknown was kind of annoying me. Now, if we really wanted to, we could void Fortune Cookie and make it worse, but that would also... allow us to have more secondary stat gainage. It's just, again, it's another one of those, like, we don't really need it. So, glad that I used the world card because I was about to go south. That would have been a huge waste of time. Spider Babby. So funny, after working with Matthias, I can't unhear Matthias's voice in everything that I hear in Isaac now. Like, even in this on this track, you hear Matthias go, "Wow!" I'm like, "Yeah, yeah, that's Matthias right there." Very fortunate. I'm extremely fortunate and honored to be able to call Matthias a friend. I never in a million years would have thought that I'd be able to call the man who plays the only voice you hear other than Mom and Isaac a friend, an actual personal friend, not like not a working acquaintance, but I mean a friend to friend. Like, we've talked about, you know, life and shared good stories, and, you know, we've created music already. Feel very, very, very blessed and honored to be able to call Matthias a friend. He's one of the nicest, realest, truest people I've ever met. Spoken to. Technically, I've not met him, but. We're going to eventually. yeah, we don't really need that. Dad's key is not really needed here. But if you didn't catch that news from last year, definitely check out the video that I did of Sinvicta calls Isaac's dad. It was a little prank that I pulled on the Twitch mosh pit. And the result was legendary. Definitely go check that out. as we that we use that as a sort of like the stepping stone to make our formal announcement that the Ward of Lauder, my band, and Planet Ridiculon, which is Matthias and John's band, also of course the creator of the Isaac soundtrack, we are joining forces to create a new band together, and we've already written a bunch of songs. None that are public yet because they're not like fully mixed or anything. Matthias and John went on tour for a while towards the tail end of last summer, and then they've been really busy with other stuff in the studio. So, but we have recorded a bunch, and really, in a million billion years, I would have never thought that I'd be able to say that I'm in a band with Matthias Bossi. That's just so freaking cool, man. I know I'm a little bit flexing here, but I'm also just kind of like geeking out because Matthias is such a great guy. If you get a chance to watch some interviews with him, you can really truly get a sense of how genuine of a guy that he is. Very, very down to earth, very humble, extremely talented, very, very smart, all around great dude, that Matthias. You can even tweet at him. Tweet at him and tell him that Sinvicta was praising him in today's Isaac episode. I'm sure he'd like that. He operates the Planet Ridiculon Twitter. What a run, man. What a fantastic run to start us off with. People have been asking me about Darkest Dungeon 2, by the way. I will not be playing Darkest Dungeon 2 on the channel. I might stream it every now and then, maybe, but like I'm not a big fan of it. I'm going to be honest. You know, I played the absolute hell out of the first one, of course. It's one of the staples of the channel. It got me one of my first celebrity interviews with Wayne June, and then eventually with Chris Barassa and the Darkest Dungeon team. Like, I was extremely honored to work with them. And you know, Darkest Dungeon definitely has a very storied history in my channel's history, but I'm not a fan of two. I didn't know that it was going to be a roguelite. I'm going to be honest. I played through the alpha, played through the beta. It wasn't my cup of tea. I didn't really like the relationship system, and I wasn't down with the just the random punishing things that could happen in the game, like even more so than in Darkest Dungeon 1. So I was really hoping that they would change that, and they didn't. but the thing that kind of turns me off to the game is just I'm not a big fan of the roguelite system, because the biggest appeal for me in Darkest Dungeon 1 was making characters, naming them after friends, naming them after subscribers, becoming attached to them, seeing them grow, seeing them how they handle problems, how they handle negative quirks, that sort of thing, and overcoming those to eventually, you know, either resulting in their death or their success at the end of the game. And it doesn't work like that in Darkest Dungeon 2. It the game hits reset every single time you kill a boss. I don't know what to say about that, other than that's how it is. Like, basically, once you kill like the chapter one boss, all the progression that you had in your characters, their names, everything, their trinkets, all that stuff resets. And then of course you retain like a certain level of meta progression in the game, but it doesn't feel meaningful to me, right? Because I want to get attached to the characters. I don't really care about unlocking stuff and doing, like, I want to recruit a jester and have him be really crappy and then turn him into like this amazing, like, godlike entity. Or those of you who've been around long enough, you remember the legend of Baynard. Baynard actually came from Darkest Dungeon. Baynard was this really, really out of nowhere occultist that ended up saving our entire run out of nowhere. Like, he made a couple of really clutch plays and eventually died a hero to save our main characters. And then Baynard became a legend in Lobotomy Corporation and in other Darkest Dungeon playthroughs. So, you know, and he became like an icon in the mosh pit, basically. So that, all of that stemmed from, you know, emergent storylines, discovering stuff about your characters, you know, just seeing how it progresses inside of the campaign and everything, and you can't get that in Darkest Dungeon 2. That's a very big turnoff for me. Now, some people are saying that Darkest Dungeon 2 is a worthy successor to Darkest Dungeon 1. It's better than the original, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, if you're having, if you're playing Darkest Dungeon 2 and you're loving it, hey, I'm happy for it. It's just not my cup of tea. So I may play it here and there on stream, but I'm not going to be doing a YouTube series on it. The way that it is, it would also be impossible to do it, I think, in an engaging and fun way. But besides that, what an incredible run. What a way to start off this week here. Thank you for watching, everyone. Thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. Remember, we're trying to get this over 3,000 likes. Let's go ahead and do that so we can get to the keyboard tracker episode and beyond. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, everybody. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Caitlin Weir, Myth Withy, and Oliver Went. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.